James. Not many of you should become teachers, my brothers and sisters, for you know that we who teach will be judged with greater strictness. For all of us make many mistakes. Anyone who makes no mistakes in speaking is perfect, able to keep the whole body in check with a bridle. If we put bits into the mouths of horses to make them obey us, we guide their whole bodies. Or look at ships. Though they are so large that it takes strong winds to drive them, yet they are guided by a very small rudder wherever the will of the pilot directs. So also, the tongue is a very small member, yet it boasts of great exploits. How great a forest is set ablaze by a small fire, and the tongue is a fire. The tongue is placed among our members as a world of iniquity. It stains the whole body, sets on fire the cycle of nature, and is itself set on fire by hell. For every species of beast and bird, of reptile and sea creature, can be tamed and has been tamed by the human species, but no one can tame the tongue, a restless evil full of deadly poison. With it, we bless the Lord and Father, and with it, we curse those who are made in the likeness of God. From the same mouth come blessing and cursing. My brothers and sisters, this ought not to be so. Does a spring pour forth from the same opening both fresh and brackish water? Can a fig tree, my brothers and sisters, yield olives? Or a grapevine, figs? No more can salt water yield fresh. Who is wise and understanding among you? Show by your good life that your works are done with gentleness, born of wisdom. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
My spirit has joy. treasure hidden in a field, which someone found and hid. Then, in his joy, he goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant in search of fine pearls. On finding one pearl of great value, he went and sold all that he had and bought it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net that was thrown into the sea and caught fish of every kind. When it was full, they drew it ashore, sat down, and put the good into baskets, but threw out the bad. So it will be at the end of the age. The angels will come out and separate the evil from the righteous and throw them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Have you understood all this? They answered, yes. And he said to them, therefore, every scribe who has been trained for the kingdom of heaven is like the master of a household who brings out of his treasure what is new and what is old. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. gifts for a variety of ministries for the common good. Today, we commission these persons before God and on behalf of this community to the particular ministry of music to which they are called as leaders of worship and prayer in this place.
Reverend Sarah, I present to you these persons to be commissioned to the ministry of the choir of St. Paul's.
Do you believe that these choir members have been prepared by prayerful intention and suitable training to exercise this ministry to the honor of God and for the nurturing of the well-being of God's church?
I believe they are.
Excellent. You have a call to deepen our life of prayer and worship through your ministry of music in this community of faith. Giving yourself to this labor of love with prayerful devotion, will you perform it with diligence?
We will.
Excellent. And you all are going to be involved in just a moment, but will you faithfully and reverently exercise these sacred responsibilities of your ministry to the honor of God and the benefit of our wider community?
We will.
And we now invite choir school parents to also stand.
Choir school parents, we would be nothing without you. Will you continue in your valiant support of your children as they participate in the ministry of the choir school at St. Paul's?
We will.
In the name of God and of this community of faith, I commission each and all of you to the choir ministry of St. Paul's Church. May be seated.
Thank you.
may be seated. I want to take this opportunity to welcome you this evening, whether you're here as a regular at Evensong or if this is your very first time. I'm Sarah Stewart, the rector of St. Paul's, and it is a joy and a privilege to welcome you to this first Evensong of the 16th year of the choir school. We are so thrilled and delighted about those who have joined the choir this year, and those of you who are continuing to grow in your gifts for song and music in this program. I invite you to continue in this ministry of presence, and through your loving gifts of prayer, presence, and generosity, to uphold the ministry of these amazing musicians in this place. So please enjoy this evening. Be sure to note the calendar and come back and be part of future offerings. And know that we are thrilled that God is drawing us deeper into the fabric of community through this community of faith. God bless you. Thank you for joining us this evening. And we look forward to knowing you better as we walk in love.
Thank you.
how we can live and love all our neighbors in Burlingame. Be with all those who suffer, whether through human violence or natural disaster, especially those in Afghanistan, Syria, Somalia, Democratic Republic of Congo, Ukraine, Russia, and Puerto Rico. For those who are targets of human hate on account of gender, identity, orientation, race, creed, or culture, that all your children would know healing love and divine protection. For all who are in trouble, sorrow, sickness, suffering, need, or any other adversity, especially those who struggle with mental health challenges and long to feel your healing light amid inner pain. For all who do not yet know the reach of your love, that mercy and kindness will surround them with the grace to seek and to find their heart's desire. For all who have died, that your care may be known. To all whom we love, all who are connected with this community of faith, hope, and love. Binding these prayers together, let us pray in the words of St. Chrysostom. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time, with one accord, to make our common supplication to you, and you have promised through your beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen.
Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father,